Now, I don't know whether you can see that some 15 minutes later, that erector spinae there is less intense than it was. And just to recap, I think that the 2 years ago surgery reduced the pressure of the intervertebral disc at L4, increasing its propensity to slip forward. And her X-ray report, her MRI report, 2 years apart, has noted that the slip has increased. I think that's a direct sequel to the reduced pressure, sometimes up to 40% of post-discectomy, and I think that has allowed the segment to slip forward. What's interesting is that this patient can feel her butt muscles switching on. She says that whenever she's stressed or feels exertion, that she can feel the muscle switching on and has no control over it. And finally, just before treatment finished, she asked me, would I mobilise S1? If you can point to where you want me to mobilise there, Jen, which is down into the coccyx. When I went to the coccyx, she said, no, that was too low. So I went to S1 here. And she says, that feels, that on the money there, Jenny?
Yes, do it.
And she says, that's beautiful pain. Now, that is well into the sacrum, but I'm still mobilising it. She feels it's agreeable. I do what the patient wants. And if you don't respond and touch that pain, then you don't get the treatment. Now, I don't know whether you can see too, that the bottom is much more relaxed now. I'm going to go back to it. I won't overdo it. She's had months of pain. It's easy to overdo anybody that's had months of pain.
Years of pain.
Correction. Okay.